Hey, do you wish you could automate some of your Excel work? Well, in this video, we go over three real-world scenarios where you can use macros to automate your repetitive tasks. And first, we'll go over some easy examples just using macros, and then we'll move on to some harder stuff using VBA. And don't worry, you don't need programming experience for this. So let's get into it. As the first example, let's hop onto Excel, and here you can see that we have a new project idea, which we want to assess, and we want to reformat all of these cells over here such that they're in gray with this blue color and the border around it. And by the way, you can download this Excel file for free in the video description. So for this, you might think of using the Format Painter, which is this brush over here. So just click on that, and then we can click on any other cell we want to format. So you can see it changes highlight color and the text color and the border, but the problem is that it also messes up with the format. So instead, I'm gonna go back by pressing Ctrl Z, and what we're gonna do is record a macro. So we're gonna go over to the developer tab for this. In case you don't have this developer tab, you just need to go over to File, then towards the bottom under Options, you're going to find the Customize ribbon. So that's the one we wanna click on. And then you wanna tick on Developer if you haven't already and hit on OK. Awesome. Once we're here, we're just gonna click on Record Macro. And this is basically going to record our set of steps. And so then we can just click a button and it's gonna do that same step for future tasks. So let's just click on Record Macro. We'll name it something like Formatting. And then for now, we're just gonna hit on OK. So the first thing we want is basically to change the color. So we're gonna go over to Home. And we're gonna change the color over here to say a dark blue like this one. Then the highlight color, we wanna change it to a gray. Let's say we go for this one here. And finally, we wanna add the borders. So right next to that, we're gonna add all borders. So that's all we need. And so we'll go back to the developer tab. This time hit the stop recording. Awesome, so we now have this macro recorded. And suppose we wanna use it for these two cells right below and these other ones here. So we just press the Control key and just drag them down. Now, what we just gotta do is click on macros and you should find the macro we just did over here and just hit on run. Great, now you'll notice that they have this new format, but the text remained in the original format of percentage here and dollar above. Next up, let's say we've got a complex financial model like this one over here that we've been working on. And because we've been working with our manager, we have quite a lot of comments, which are these things in red, which if you hover over them, you can see that it's just some commentary from our manager, for example. Now, let's suppose that you've worked on all of these and you now want to remove them, but there's quite a lot of these. So what we're gonna have to do is record a macro so we can do it every time in just one click. So again, we'll go up to record macro. We'll call this one something like comment, hit okay there. And then what we're gonna wanna do is go over to home. Then all the way to the side, you'll find the find and select option. And specifically, we're gonna select all of these notes, which are the comments basically. So we'll go to special. And here you can see that we can select a ton of different things from blanks, but in this case, we'll go for notes. So we'll just hit on okay there. And here you'll notice that all of them have now been selected. So then we can just go over to one of them and right click, and then just hit on delete note. That's gonna delete all of them for us in one go. And so now we just go back to the developer and hit on stop recording. If I move down to the next tab, you'll see that we have the same commentary, but I've also added some more comments over here to the side, so we can see if the macro also removes these. So we'll go over to macros, and this time we'll select the comment one and just hit on run. And you'll see just like that in one click, it's removed all of the comments, including these to the side. In case you find it tedious to have to go to developer and click on macros, we can actually just insert something like a button. So we'll go over to insert, and it's gonna be this one over here, so the button, and we're just gonna drag it like so. And here we basically wanna link it to the comment one, which is the one that removes the comments for us. So we'll hit on okay. To rename it, I'm just gonna click inside it and call it something like no comments, like so. And then now let's suppose I add a new comment here just by going to right click and say new note. Let me call this like test. So we have this new comment, and now let's suppose I want to remove it. So I'm just going to click on this button, and you can see that it's gotten rid of it like so. One important thing to note is that you can select whether you want a macro for one sheet or for all Excel sheets. So for example, let's say I click on record macro. Down over here, you can see that it has a few different options. One is that it's only for a new workbook, for this current workbook you're working on, or for personal macro workbook, which basically means that whenever you open up a new Excel file, that macro is always going to be in there. So depending on how useful you think the macro is, you could have it in your personal macro workbook, so you can use it across all your Excel files. And if you're liking this video and you're looking for more Excel material, you can consider checking out our Excel for Business and Finance course. And what makes this course different is that it's all applied to the real world. While we still cover theoretical lessons like formatting, formulas, and charts, we also offer case studies that simulate the type of work you might be assigned in your day-to-day, ranging from financial modeling to cleaning a data set and presenting some visual insights. And if you get stuck along the way, you can always ask us questions in the discussions forum. We also offer several other courses, including Power BI, Finance and Valuation, and more. So if you're interested, go to the link in the description below. All right, back to the video. And finally, we have the third and hardest example. Here, you can see that we've got a new Excel file, and let's suppose that every week we receive new data for the 5 products that we sell. And ideally, we need to break this down into 5 separate sheets, so product 1, product 2, and so on. On top of that, we need to format the sheets, so each one needs to be called weekly sales, we need to remove the grid lines, and a bunch of different things, which makes it quite tedious. So to automate this, we're going to use a macro, but this time it's also going to require a bit of programming. But the steps here at first are going to be the same, so we'll head over to the developer, just hit on record macro. Let's call this one something like product, and let me just hit on OK. So these are the steps we want to take. First, we're going to add a new sheet, and let's call this something like product. Hit enter there, and then we'll go over to B2 and just do Alt-W-V-G. That's going to remove the grid lines for us, and we'll call this something like weekly sales. And let's reformat this by boldening it, so Control-B, and underlining by Control-U. So let's suppose that we need to do this for each product, so product 1, product 2, and so on. That's where we're going to have to go back to the developer tab, and first hit on stop recording. And now we're going to head over inside the code, so just click on this Visual Basic here. Here, towards the bottom, you'll find the product macro. This is basically all the steps that we've taken so far. So you can see right now that it says, hey, to create a new sheet, then it also says to rename that sheet into product, and then it says to remove the grid lines, so display grid lines equals false. Then it also says to type in weekly sales in this B2 range and to make it bold and underlined as well. So that's basically all of the code that it's written. What we need to do is add a bit more so that we can add all of the 5 sheets. So first, at the very beginning here, we're going to hit enter to add a new row, and we'll write dim x as integer. That's what we're gonna want. We need this dim here to declare a variable and basically assign that x is going to be an integer where x is going to be equals to 1. So it's gonna be product 1, 2, 3, etc. That said, we only want 5 products, so we're going to have to put some kind of a cap. And for that, we're gonna do while x is less than or equal to 5. Then right below, you can see here that it says to add a new sheet, which we're happy with. This right below it, we don't really need, so we're just gonna delete that. And then you can see here that it says sheet 2 is going to equal to product. We don't want it to activate the sheet 2, so instead we're going to do active sheet. And then call that product, but it's not just product, right? We want it to be product 1, 2, 3, and so on. So what we're going to have to do here is add an ampersand, and then we're going to add the x. That said, we also want to add a bit of space, so that there's a space between the product and the number. Then we'll hit enter, because we want that x to move, right? We don't want it to stay at only 1. So what we'll do is go to x equals x plus 1. That way it's going to keep going up in increments, but up until 5 as we've specified up over here. Finally, we want it to take all of these steps, so adding the grid lines, the title, and so on, for all of the sheets, so we'll leave that. And at the very end, we're gonna have to do a loop such that it does it for all 5. Awesome, now that we've done this, we just need to close out of it. You don't really need to save, so just hit X there, and let's try see if this actually works. So we'll go over to macros, and then it's gonna be the product one, and I'm just gonna hit on run. And you can see that it's generated 5 product sheets where it goes from 1 all the way to 5. They're all formatted without these grid lines and with the title inside them. So it's all looking good there. In this case, the example was for 5 products, but it could be for 10 products, for all the days in a week, and so on as well. Finally, before we exit Excel, we're going to need to save this. So just hit on F12. But this time we can't save it as a normal Excel workbook. Instead, it's gonna need to be a macro-enabled one, which basically means that it's gonna allow for macros to be run, and just hit on save there. For more on macros, check out this video over here, or you can take our Excel course over here. Hit that like and that subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.